Hi students, in today's session I am going to discuss an excellent trick to find number of geometrical isomers and optical isomers for coordination compounds. Let us start. Geometrical isomerism. For tetrahedral complexes, there is no geometrical isomerism, because if you see, suppose this is a complex, here the angle between these two is 109 degree 28 minute, and here also the angle is same, here also the angle is same, here also the angle is same. So if you change these two, A and B, D, if you flip like this, then you get the same angle between the two. Means there is no change in the stereo, means space. Then these tetrahedral complexes do not exhibit GI. Let us see case 2. Now see for square planar complexes. First one is MEA4. MEA4. First, draw the structure like this. Metal at the center and four ligands are there. See, observe carefully students, you will get your trick also. MA4 ligands are there. All are same, right? Now, what you do is, just you flip these two. When you flip these two, we get the same structure, because here also A, here also A. There is no GI for MA4. Coming to this MA3B, what you do is, just draw the structure A, 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 B, and just flip the structure. If you flip this structure, means A and B, what happens here is A is same, and if you, when we interchange these two, we get B here and A here. Then if you observe carefully, to this A, perpendicular thing is A, and A perpendicular to A is B. Here also same, to the A perpendicular to A is B, and here also perpendicular to this is A. Both are same. After interchanging also, we are not getting any different structure. So to this also no geometrical isomerism. And MA2B2. See, for every time writing like this and finding the geometrical isomers, little bit it takes some time in your exams. Now, as your favorite, let us discuss the trick. What you do is, just you see, number of combinations are possible. To this A2B2, the number of combinations are, you can write, how many combinations are possible? We can write A2 as AA. Take two ligands and take as one set. B2, BB. This is one combination. And another combination is, we can interchange this A and B. Then what you get? AB, AB. Right? Then how many? One more is possible? No, it's not possible. So the number of geometrical isomers are 2. Is it clear, students? How many GIs are possible to this? 2. What are those 2? AA. A to A, opposite is A. And to B, opposite is B. And here, to A, perpendicular is B. And A, perpendicular is B. So, what you get? Both are same. Just for your understanding. Right, AA are opposite to each other, so this is trans, and here both are side by side, then it is cis. How many isomers are possible? 2. Here, now coming to the trick, how to do this trick, students? A4, right? How many combinations are possible? AA, only one is possible, means only one isomer, no other thing is possible. Here A3B, how can we write? What is the trick? AA, AB. That's it. So that's why there is no GI. And MABCD, once you try, MABCD, how to write? ABCD. Correct? If you change it, what we can get? ACBD. And what one more we can get? BC, AD. So total how many GIs are possible? Number of geometrical isomers are 3. What you do is just find out how many combinations are possible. Then those combinations you should take it as number of geometrical isomers. Okay. Now let us discuss for octahedral complexes. Now let us see the number of optically active isomers are possible for a particular structure. If you pass the plane polarized light through the nickel prism or through a particular solution, if there is no change in the light, then that particular coordination compound is optically inactive. If the particular molecule is turning the light either towards the right or towards the left, then the particular coordination compound is optically active, right? And if it is optically active, if it is rotating the light towards the right side, then we call it as dextrorotatory. If it is rotating towards the left, then we call it as levorotatory. Means for optically active form, two isomers are possible. One is D, another one is L. Right? Now, for tetrahedral complexes, see students, observe carefully. For tetrahedral complexes like MA4 type, if you see A, right? If you put in, if you take its mirror image, what we get? If you take its mirror image, we get the, this is back of the plane. We get the same structure. So this molecule, this kind of molecules do not show the optical activity. And if you take MABCD type, here what happens is, take its mirror image. Its mirror image, C comes here, B comes here, this B comes here. So both are, if you try to superimpose this on this molecule, observe carefully. If you put this molecule on this, both are non-superimposable. Means both are not same, right? Then these non-superimposable mirror images, they shows optical activity. What is the condition, students? Mirror images should not be superimposable. Optically active. What is the conditions? What is the condition? Mirror image should not be superimposable. This is the thing, right? Now let us see the trick for octahedral complexes. Let us discuss one more time both geometrical isomerism and as well as optical isomerism. Really, it is very, very important and nice also. See the first one, octahedral complex MA6. How many geometrical isomers are possible and how many optical isomers are possible? That is your question. So only one combination is possible. If only one combination is possible, no other combination, so no GI. And one trick for you to find optical isomerism. Excellent trick. If any pair has same ligands like AA, or any two pairs are same like ABAB, then they are optically inactive. This is your trick, right? Now here AA, same pair is there, right? If same pair is there, what is the students? This is optically inactive. Fine. Second one. MA5B. How many combinations are possible to this? AA, AA, AB. Right? No other combination is possible. So, no GI. And this is optically, optically inactive. Next. MA4B2. How many combinations are possible? AA, AA, BB. And AA, just change this. AB, one more AB. Any other? No other combination. So number of GI is? Number of GI is 2. Clear? And if you see, same ligand is there. So optically inactive. And here also same ligand, optically inactive. It won't show optical activity. No optical, optical activity. No optical activity. Coming to the fourth one. MA3B2C. How many combinations are possible? Just write down all the combinations. AA, AB, BC. Next, AA, AC, BB. AB, AB, AC. So, number of GI, how many students? Number of GI is equal to 3. And it is optically active or not? AA, same ligand, optical inactive. Same ligand, optical inactive. In this, two pairs also same. So, it is also optically inactive. Means this coordination compound is optically inactive. No optical activity. Number 5. Just to try this 3. Click on pass and try MA3B3, right? How many combinations are possible? AA, AB, BB. And one more is AB, AB, AB. So total 2 GI. Number of GI is equal to 2. And this is optically active or not? This is not optically active, and this is 2 are same. Same pairs are there. So optically inactive. Optically inactive. Next. MA3BCD, right? How many combinations are possible? AA, AB, CD. This is one combination. And one more combination. AA, just I am changing this to AC, BD. And one more is, I will change these two. AB, AC, AD. And one more. A root BDL, right? Huh. Then AA, AA, AD, BC. So total how many are possible? Number of geometrical isomers are, geometrical isomers are how many? 4. In this, how many are optically active? This is optically inactive. This is also optically inactive. This is optical. Only this is optically active. And how many are possible to this? To this, one is D form is possible, L form. So, optically active forms are how many students? 2. You should count this. You should not take it as 1. It should show D form as well as L form. So, number of optical active isomers are 2. And optically inactive isomers, how many? Optically inactive isomers are 1, 2 and 3. Now total stereoisomers, how many? Stereoisomers. Stereoisomers means you should count both optically active and optically inactive. So total 5 stereoisomers are possible. Is it clear? Now what you do is, to this MA2B2C2, just you take the all combinations and take all combinations and find number of geometrical isomers and number of optical isomers and number of stereoisomers. That is your question. Test yourself. See here, optical isomers are possible. You should count both D and L, and you should comment me your stereoisomers. I hope this video is useful for you. Thanks for watching.